it means you can't sulfate your vitamin D. If you can't sulfate your vitamin D, you know what happens? It doesn't do anything to calcium. Everybody believes that vitamin D is linked to calcium homeostasis in the gut. It turns out that sulfated vitamin D and unsulfated vitamin D have different physiologic benefits. So this is how, a small little way, how this works. What else is sulfated? Every bit of your platelets and your blood that's floating in there is sulfated. What else? Your white blood cells. Your white blood cells are able to make sulfate directly from H2S made from your microbiome with no enzymatic machinery needed, provided you can sulfate the blood from your gut or your skin. The microbiome is the backup system for your skin when you don't have your skin in the game. Mm-hmm. And it turns out your gut absolutely also needs to be in the game, because what people don't realize is that red light is the one part of sunlight that penetrates directly through your skin all the way to every part of your gut. It penetrates 10 to 30 centimeters. So that means that every bit of red light from the sun, which is the dominant frequency in sunlight, for those of you who don't know, in terrestrial sunlight, 42% is infrared A light. That is what mitochondria are interested in. Mm-hmm. And every single mitochondria in your gut is looking for that. Turns out the microbiome is also interested in that red light. Now, blue light does penetrate us, but it only penetrates about 3 to 6 centimeters. So for the gut, it's usually not that big a deal. But where do we get the blue light information? We tend to get it from our red blood cells, through our skin and our eye. It also does happen in the gut. But how does it happen in the gut? Here's where the counterintuitive story comes. Well, when things get sulfated, there's two big things that go on in your liver. You've probably heard about methylation and detoxification. Those things are heavily dependent on sulfating proteins in your body. For example, the accumulation of metals in your body. Many of the functional medicine doctors are out there telling people when you eat things through your gut, like, for example, the thing that drives me crazy, they tell people if you eat too much tuna, you're going to get mercury, which is total bullshit. Wow. But the real problem that happens if your microbiome is off and your methionine cycle is off, your methionine cycle needs the sulfation to clear heavy metals. So you know what that means? You don't even need to eat a lot of things with methylmercury in it at all. Because guess what? If the sulfation process is broken in your microbiome over your life, you will become a net collector and can't get rid of the heavy metals. Mm. Guess what else happens if you're not sulfated? You'll actually develop methylation defects. See, the dominant paradigm out there right now from the functional medicine guys is that methylation defects come from what? A problem with your SNPs that you get on a 23andMe test. Mm-hmm. Turns out it's not true. And how do we know that? I'm going to tell you, there's another B vitamin in the gut that's really important. It's called riboflavin. Riboflavin is B2. Guess what? B2 is a cofactor in all these sulfation pathways that we're talking about. Do you know what kind of chromophore